Hi. Good morning, all of you. Today I am going to the hydraulic turbines. Okay. Next class. Sorry. Before I will explain the turbine, the working principle of a turbine, and the classifications of turbines. And reaction turbines. Today I am going to the transistor turbine. Transistor turbine is a one type of reaction turbine. In reaction turbines,
sir.
Sir,
stuck అయిపోతుంది.
అందుకే ఆపున్నానమ్మా. ఇన్ రియాక్షన్ టర్బైన్స్ ద రన్నర్ యూటిలైజెస్ బోత్ పొటెన్షియల్ అండ్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీస్. Reaction turbines used only potential energy and kinetic energy. Before I can explain Pelton wheel turbine, this turbine used only kinetic energy. In this turbines, potential energy and kinetic energy both are utilized. As shown in the diagram, this is a Francis turbine. Okay, in this Francis turbine, this is a shaft. This part is guide blades, spiral casing, runner, and draft tube. This portion is tail race. Okay, this is a penstock. Okay, this is a guide blades. Okay, as shown in the figure, as compared to the Pelton wheel turbine, as the same, because of in this turbine, extra part is draft tube and tail races. Okay, this is a guide blade mechanism, and this part is used in the same Pelton wheel turbine and Francis turbine. Okay, this is the design of Francis turbine. This figure is general layout of hydroelectric power plant by using of reaction turbine. Okay, reaction turbine means both potential energy అండ్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీస్ ఆర్ యూటిలైజెస్. ఓకే, ఇంపల్స్ టర్బైన్ మీన్స్ ఓన్లీ పొటెన్షియల్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీస్ ఆర్ యూటిలైజెస్. ఓకే, ఇండక్షన్ సార్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ సార్ ఫ్రాన్సిస్ టర్బైన్ అండ్ కెప్లాన్ టర్బైన్. ఇంపల్స్ టర్బైన్స్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ ఆర్ పెల్టన్ వీల్. పెల్టన్ వీల్ ఈజ్ ఆల్రెడీ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్ ఇన్ దిస్ ఫిగర్. దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ హైడ్రో ఎలక్ట్రిక్ పవర్ ప్లాంట్.
In this power plant, this is a dam, this part is reservoir, this part is penstock, okay, generator, reaction turbine, draft tube and tail race. Okay, in reaction turbine means Francis or Kaplan, both turbines are used in this figure. Okay, dam, the working of a dam to store the energy, water energy. They stored out the water and entering into the water penstock. In penstock, end of the penstock, the nozzle is connected. Okay, nozzle purpose is the pressure energy is converted into the velocity energy. Okay, high velocity of water striking up the reaction turbine. Okay, because of the reaction turbine is rotating, the shaft is rotating, the shaft energy is stored in the generator. That energy is electrical energy. Okay. Next. The net head at the turbine. Hg equal to gross head. Hf equal to the loss of head in the penstock. Okay. H equal to net head. That equal to Hg minus HF. Okay, therefore H equal to total energy available at exit from the penstock minus total energy available at the exit from the draft tube. Okay, this is the Bernoulli's equation, penstock and draft tube. Okay, P by W plus V square by 2G plus Z. This is a Bernoulli's equation. P by W means potential energy and V square by 2G means kinetic energy and Z means datum energy. Okay, this Bernoulli's equation penstock. This Bernoulli's equation is used in draft tube. Okay, therefore H equal to P by W plus V square by 2G plus Z. Okay, minus VD square by 2G. Okay, VD square by 2G is by using of draft tube formula. Okay, therefore H equal to P by W plus V square by 2G plus Z. Okay, next, work done and efficiency of a Francis turbine. Work done equal to rho q u1 plus or minus vw2 u2. Okay, vw1 u1 are flow velocity and whirl velocity. Okay, therefore q is the discharge through the runner. That equal to meter cube per second. Next, the maximum output under the condition is obtained when VWT equal to zero. Okay, work done equal to WQ by G into VW1 V1. Next, this is the velocity diagram for an inward flow reaction turbine. Okay, this is a wheel. Okay, center wheel R2 R1, okay, now R2 is the inner radius of the wheel. R1 is the outer radius of the wheel. Okay, the outlet velocity diagram. This is the inlet velocity diagram. Okay, this is the tangent of at B, and this is the tangent of at B. Okay, this is a B dash inlet tip and outlet tip. Okay, A, B, C, D. D is the velocity diagram at inlet. Okay, this is the velocity diagram at outlet. Okay, V1, VR1, VF1, theta, alpha, U1, V double one. These terms are inlet terms. Velocity and alpha and theta. The water is entering into the wheel. Angles and velocities. This pi beta are the water is leaving from the wheel. Okay, next, hydraulic efficiency. If H is the net head, then input to the turbine WQH. Hydraulic efficiency equal to power developed by the runner by power supplied to the runner. Therefore, hydraulic efficiency equal to VW1 U1 GH. Okay, next. Mechanical efficiency. Okay, the mechanical efficiency is shaft power by power delivered by the runner. It means shaft power by runner power. Okay, next, overall efficiency. Overall efficiency means shaft power by water power. That equal to P by WQH. Therefore, overall efficiency equal to hydraulic efficiency and mechanical efficiency. The overall efficiency varies from 80 to 90%. Next, the working proportions of a Francis turbine. Ratio of width to diameter, B by D. The ratio of B1 to the diameter of the wheel, D1. At inlet, represented by N. Okay, thus N equal to B1 by D1. The N varies from next, flow ratio KF. The flow ratio of the velocity of flow at inlet to the theoretical jet velocity. Okay, therefore, the flow ratio equal to KF equal to VF1 by root of 2GH. The KF varies from 0.15 to 0.30. Next, speed ratio. Speed ratio equal to U by root of 2GH. The KU ranges from 0.6 to 0.9. Okay, in this flow ratio and speed ratio and ratio of width to diameter, these equations are used in the small problems. Okay, next. This is the small problem of a Francis turbine. An inward flow reaction turbine has external and internal diameters 1.08 meters and 0.54 meters. The turbine is running at 200 rpm The width of the turbine at inlet is 240 mm and velocity of flow through the runner is constant and equal to 2.16 meter per second. The guide blade makes an angle 10 degrees to the tangent of the wheel and discharge at the outlet of the turbine is radial. Draw the inlet and outlet velocity triangles and determine the absolute velocity of the water at inlet of the runner, the velocity of the whirl at inlet, the relative velocity at inlet, the runner blade angles, width of the runner at outlet, weight of the water flowing through the runner per second, head inlet of the turbine, power developed and hydraulic efficiency of the turbine. This is a one type of a problem of Francis turbine, inward radial pore reaction turbine. Okay, most important problems in these models. Okay, to solve the problem. Okay, first of all, to write down the given data, external diameter, internal diameter, speed, width at inlet, velocity of flow at inlet, guide blade angle. This is the inlet variables. D1 equal to 1.08 meters, D2 equal to 0.54 meters, N equal to 200 RPM, P1 equal to 240 RPM, 240 mm. Therefore, this is converted into the meters. Okay. Velocity of flow VF1 equal to VF2 equal to 2.16 meter per second. Guide blade angle alpha equal to 10 degrees. Okay. Next, discharge at outlet radial. Okay. Discharge at outlet. Ante outlet diagram. E beta equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, VW equal to 0. Already explained the velocity diagram of the wheel. Beta equal to 90 degrees and VWT equal to 0. This condition is given in the problem. Okay. Next, tangential velocity of the wheel at inlet. Okay. Inlet velocity U1 equal to pi dn by 60. Okay. That equal to pi d1 n already given in the problem. These values are substituted in this equation to calculate the U1 equal to 11.31 meter per second. Next, U2 is calculated. Pi D2 N by 60. D2 N already given in the problem. These values are substituted in this equation to calculate the U2 value, that equal to 5.65 meter per second. Okay, tangential velocity of wheel at inlet and tangential velocity of wheel at outlet. U1 and U2 is calculated. Next, absolute velocity of water at inlet of the runner V1 from the velocity triangles. Okay, velocity triangle nunchi V1 sin alpha equal to VF1. Okay, therefore V1 equal to VF1 by sin alpha, 2.16 by sin alpha means 10 degrees, that equal to 12.44. Next, velocity of wheel at inlet, VW1 equal to V1 cos alpha. V1 is already calculated, alpha is already given in the problem 10 degrees. Therefore, VW1 is calculated, that equal to 12.25. meter per second. Okay, this is a velocity diagram of a in this problem. Okay, first of all, to draw the velocity diagram, to read the problem and draw the velocity diagram. Okay, next, third point, relative velocity of inlet VR1. VR1 equal to root of VW1 minus U1 square plus VF1 square. These values are substituted in this equation to calculate the VR1. That equal to 2.35 meter per second. Okay, next, runner blade angles, theta and pi. Okay, this is the velocity triangle. Tan theta equal to, okay, VF1 by VW1 U1. Okay, tan theta equal to VF1 by VW1 minus E1. Okay, means VF1 divided by this small length. Okay, that equal to VW1 minus U1. Tan theta equal to VF1 by VW1 minus U1. Okay, that value is calculated. Okay, theta equal to 66.48 from outlet triangles. Tan theta equal to VF2 by U2. VF2 by U2. Okay, tan pi, sorry, this is the tan pi, that equal to VF2 by U2. U2. Okay, VF2 by U2, that equal to pi. Pi is calculated 20.9 degrees. Okay, these values are calculated in the by using of a velocity triangle diagram. Next, head at the inlet turbine. That equal to 1 by G VW1 U1 plus or minus VW2 U2 plus V2 square by 2G. That equal to 1 by G VW1 U1 because of VW2 equal to 0. Okay, therefore, all values are substituted in this equation to calculate the inlet of the turbine H equal to 14.36 meters. Okay, power developed. Power developed equal to rho Q VW1 U1. That equal to WQ by G into VW1 U1. Therefore, the calculated value is 243.6 kilowatts. Next, hydraulic efficiency. Hydraulic efficiency equal to VW1 U1 by GH. This is the formula of hydraulic efficiency. Okay, that equal to 98.35%. Okay. This is the same problem. Francis turbine. Okay. And to read the problem and first of all to write it down the given data to calculate the runner vane angle, the velocity of wheel, both are inlet, the absolute velocity of water leaving the guide vane, the relative velocity of water entering in the runner blade. Okay. First, the runner weight of water passing through the runner or turbine, area blocked by the vane thickness. Okay, 10 by 1000 pi d1 b1 that equal to 0.1 pi d1 b1. Next, actual area A equal to pi d1 b1 minus 0.1 pi d1 b1 that equal to 0.7068 meter square. Next, weight of the water passing per second through the turbine, that equal to W into A into VF1, that equal to 9.81 into 0.7068 into 2, that equal to 13.68 kilonewton per second. Next, the runner wave angle at inlet theta. First of all, to find out the velocity. Okay, U1 equal to pi d1 n by 60. pi into d into n divided by 60. That equal to 10.99 meter per second. Okay, from nth triangle, tan alpha equal to Vf1 by Vw1. Okay, this value is taken from the triangular diagram. Okay, velocity triangular diagram. Vf1 equal to 2.0. Next, therefore, Vw1. Next, therefore, Vw1 equal to 11.34 meter per second. Next, tan pi equal, tan theta equal to Vf1 by Vf1 minus U1. That equal to 5.714. Therefore, theta equal to 80.07 degrees. Next, the velocity of wheel at inlet U1. U1 equal to 10.99 meter per second. Okay, already calculated in the equation. U1 equal to pi dn by 60. Next, the absolute velocity of water leaving the guide vanes V1 sin alpha equal to Vf1 by V1. Sin alpha equal to Vf1 by V1. Okay, that equal to V1 equal to 2.0 by sin 10. That equal to 11.52 meter per second. Okay, next. The relative velocity of water entering in the turbine blade Vr1. Sin theta equal to Vf1 divided by Vr1. Vf1 divided by Vr1. This is the sin theta. In this formula taken from the diagram. Okay, sin theta equal to Vf1 by Vr1. Therefore, to calculate the Vr1, 2.03 meter per second. Okay. Next. This is the small problem of a Francis turbine. A Francis turbine, the overall efficiency is 76% is required to produce 150 kilowatts power. It is working under a head of 8 meters. The peripheral velocity equal to 0.25 root of 2gh and radial velocity of the flow at inlet 0.95 root of 2gh. The wheel runs at a 150 rpm and hydraulic losses in the turbine are 20% of the available energy. Assuming the radial discharge, you determine guide blade angle, wheel vane angle at inlet, diameter of the wheel at inlet, and width of the wheel at inlet. First of all, to write down the problem or to read the problem, to write down the given data. The overall efficiency means 76%. The shaft power produced, P equal to 150 kilowatts, already given in the problem. Head equal to 8 meters, okay, already given in the problem. Next, peripheral velocity, U equal to 0.25 root of 2gh. This is the problem, U equal to root of 2gh. Next, radial velocity of flow at inlet, Vf1 equal to 0.95 root of 2gh. Wheel speed. Okay, wheel speed n equal to 150 rpm. Okay, this is the given data. Okay, next, discharge at the outlet is radial. Okay, radial means alpha equal to 90 degrees, that equal to Vw equal to 0, Vf2 equal to V2. Okay, the hydraulic losses in the turbine, 20% of the available energy. Okay, therefore U1 equal to 0.25 root of 2GH. Okay, therefore VF1 equal to 0.95 root of 2GH. Okay, therefore U1 is calculated 3.13 meter per second. VF1 equal to 7.9 meter per second. Okay, next, the hydraulic efficiency equal to the total head at the inlet minus hydraulic losses divided by total head at inlet. Okay, that equal to H minus 0.2H divided by H. 0.2H means 20% of available energy. That equal to 0.2H. Okay, that equal to 0.82. Therefore, the hydraulic efficiency means VW1 U1 divided by GH. Okay, the hydraulic efficiency is 0.H, that equal to VW1 U1 means 3.13 divided by G means 9.81 into H means H. Therefore, to calculate the VW1 equal to 20.0 meter per second. Okay, first, the guide blade angle alpha, tan alpha equal to VF1 by VW1. This formula is taken from the velocity triangle. Okay, VF1 equal to 11.9, VW1 equal to 20, that equal to 0.595. Therefore, to calculate the alpha equal to 30.75. Next, the wheel vane angle at inlet theta, tan theta equal to VF1 by VW1 U1. Okay, this is also taken from the velocity triangle diagram. Okay, therefore to calculate the theta value. Next, diameter of the wheel at D1, U1 equal to pi dn by 60. Already known this problem, known this equation. In this equation, to calculate the D1 value. Okay, this is the velocity diagram. Okay. Tan alpha. In this, tan alpha equal to VF1 by VW1. Okay. VF1 by VW1. Tan alpha equal to VF1 by VW1. Okay. Tan theta equal to VF1 by VW1 minus U1. Okay, in this velocity inlet diagram, to taken from the tan alpha and tan theta. Okay, next, overall efficiency. Overall efficiency means shaft power by water power. Shaft power means P. Water power means WUH. Okay, therefore, overall efficiency 0.76, that equal to 150 divided by 9.81 into Q into 8. Therefore, Q equal to 2.515 meter cube per second. Okay, Q equal to pi d1 b1 into VF1. This is the discharge formula. Pi d1 b1 into VF1. In this equation, to calculate the b, the width of the blades. Okay, that equal to 0.169 meters. Okay. The problem is completed. Okay, this is the small example problems. You can solve the number of problems by using of a hydraulic machines by Bansal textbook or Rajput textbook.